guys, what's up? It's SuperSonic857 here today, presenting to you all a different kind of video. And today we are going to be doing a speculation video on Sonic Forces with a few members of the Sonic Squad. So why don't you go ahead and introduce yourselves?
Hey guys, what's up? This is the Ninja Gamer of NinjaGaming101, and I am very happy to be here.
Hey yo, what's up? It's DarkSpawn457 here, and just as happy as Ninja to be here too.
Hey, what's up everyone? This is the Sonic Gamer here, and you know, just feeling the same.
That was a pretty unenthusiastic intro.
I know, but
good job.
I give you props for unenthusiasticness.
It's 10 out of 10 IGN.
Yeah. But anyways, let's go ahead and get into this speculation on Sonic Forces. So what is the first topic that we want to talk about, guys?
The gameplay style. Let's start out with the gameplay.
Yeah.
So what do we think of the gameplay?
So as all we see is Sonic running through this about to be destroyed city. This city
about to be, boy. Are you blind?
No,
look at Eggman.
This city honestly reminds me of Rooftop Run.
It reminds me of Spagonia. Rooftop Run,
Crescent City.
Green Hill Zone.
City Escape. And something else that I'm forgetting.
We'll get into
Green Hill Zone.
Oh, yeah, Green Hill, yeah.
Yeah, this level is actually giving me a Sonic Chronicles vibe.
Ooh, yeah,
well,
there's
obviously going to be a time paradox in it.
Yeah, time
Green
travel.
Hill.
It's going to be like a time travel story.
Yeah, it's obviously time travel since classic Sonic is there.
Yeah, true.
I don't really know what the third gameplay style is going to be.
Yeah, because all they revealed.
I don't think it would be good.
No, Dreamcast. Yeah. No, get out.
It's basically classic Sonic. Dreamcast Sonic is basically classic Sonic, just a little bit more grown up.
Bro, Sega, if you're watching this video, please.
They are not watching this video. Dude.
They wouldn't watch this video for all the money in the world.
Okay, you know who I think that the third
Sonic
gameplay
Sonic.
Style is?
Oh, heck no.
I think the girl. I think the third gameplay style is gonna be
the new
Sonic and classic Sonic at the exact same time.
That actually sounds good. Would it be like Sonic 2? Like, would it be like Sonic 2 with Sonic and Tails?
Yeah,
I think they would somehow
like a transition through
gameplay elements and just merge the two together.
Like two and a half D.
I think they would do it with like how they did the final boss in Generation. So like if you press a certain button, you could switch between modern.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah. So in other words, it's a transition between modern and classic Sonics, in generations.
I've been trying to say that the whole time.
Have you guys noticed that we're Sonic Heroes? We're Sonic Forces.
Oh my gosh!
What if it's like a Heroes 2?
It probably is not going to be bad. At the same time, it might.
I think for the next thing, like, we should talk about
where this game takes place.
Yeah, the story. Yeah, that was actually what I was about to say.
Yeah, like, what game does this game?
I think Chronicles,
getting an 06 and a Chronicles vibe from this. Like, what if this
I'm
happened?
I'm getting a headache.
Bruh.
All these people talking at the same time, like, bruh.
Where it's a brand new story.
Like, the story has Eggman conquering the world almost, and Sonic has to take a stand. Like, hold up.
I think what happened is that Eggman realized that his modern efforts weren't working, but then he looked at his past and saw that the Death Egg robot pretty much almost worked. He just needs to mass produce it, so then he goes to the past, and then he mass produces them. Possibly with classic Dr. Eggman, or Robotnik, or whatever you want to call that man. And then he, for whatever reason, brought modern Sonic into that time, like the stupid self he is, and they worked together to join forces and stuff.
teamwork.
But hold up, I thought that
Sonic Forces. Yeah.
Hold up, I thought that only the modern Eggman was the villain in this game, because I wouldn't think that they'd bring back classic
they said
Eggman.
That Eggman was the villain, but they didn't. Yeah. Yeah, they didn't
specify two Eggmans though. It was quoted by TSZ News that Shun Nakamura basically gave us this quote on the story, saying the world was conquered by Eggman, so what was Sonic doing till then? So I'm thinking that Eggman might have done something to delay Sonic. So then, like, do you guys get the gist of what I'm trying to say? Like,
yeah, I think what, I do.
Honestly,
like, what if Eggman did something to hold Sonic back, and then he was able to unveil this huge plan by destroying the city?
Oh my god, I got another idea of what this might be. What if instead of what I just said, Eggman somehow like merged all of the Sonic timelines together as one, and that's why we have Green Hill, City Escape, Rooftop Run, all in the same level.
That's a little too extreme.
I think that might be it, because that would explain a lot.
My theory was that they were merged in the level, why everyone was there, why there are Sonic forces.
Like, what if...
I don't even know if I said this before, but have you guys noticed in the gameplay, in the background, you can see that there's someone shooting at the Death Egg robots with lasers.
I actually didn't see that.
I'm about to rewatch it.
There are obviously two forces:
Sonic's forces and Eggman's forces. His giant Doom bots and whatnot. So then I guess Sonic's forces are teaming up to beat Eggman's forces.
Obviously. My old theory was that
that
classic Sonic, the classic Eggman from Generations, realized his mistakes with his future self. So he did what modern Eggman couldn't do, and he decided to rebuild the Death Egg. And then he went into modern Sonic's time and then took over the city. That's what was my old theory.
But there was a theory going around that this might have had this might take place in classic Sonic's world. Which is incredibly impossible, by the way.
Because how do we have cities?
Yeah.
I like how IGN uploads Sonic Forces gameplay even though they said Sonic was never good. Oh yeah, I see it now.
For the views, probably.
Yeah, for the views. For the likes.
Oh, I see the person
like
shooting at them
dislikes.
Now.
Dislikes, ha 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 ha.
Oh yeah, I do see the forces
last
now.
Last time I do it, please.
So I guess the next topic we can talk about is what kind of gameplay style Sonic would have.
Like Sonic's, did Sonic's, really Sonic's, all, Sonic's,
no,
all,
like we,
Sonic's.
We just went over the gameplay, but like, you know, we see Whips, well, Wisp Castle.
Oh wait, one more thing about the story. I also think this is gonna be like a random story, and it's so, I don't know why, it reminds me of the comics, because remember how the comics Eggman took over Sonic?
Yeah,
I don't know
true.
Why, but
nope.
That could be
yeah,
cool.
But this game isn't having anything to relate with the comics. It's not like the Freedom Fighters are gonna come out of nowhere, like.
Yeah,
honestly,
I don't see this game. I
love the comics as much as the next guy, but I do not want them in a video game. Yet.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
especially not a 25th anniversary.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. Bruh. I would like. Oh my gosh.
I see what you mean. I'd rather have that as like a spin-off game.
Yeah. True.
Either that, or just have like one of the Freedom Fighters, like Sally Acorn or something, show up in old games.
No.
I don't see.
Not even that would be good.
Isn't Sally dead in the comics though? Like, didn't she die?
No, she came back to life or something.
I don't read all of them. Probably not.
I remember reading one where Sally died, but let's get on to the gameplay.
But whatever. We don't care about the comics, okay, my boys.
Okay, but like
about
the gameplay though.
About the classic Sonic forces his way into another game. Let's go.
Awesome, but like the gameplay trailers. Sonic gets the Whisk Castle, Sonic boosts. So this could this be like Sonic Colors? where it's like you don't collect
Could be like Sonic Colors when you gain boost. Yeah, like it could be like that.
Or could have both.
Like, to be honest, it didn't really. And also,
I didn't like that.
Or could have both like wisps and rings to help you boost. It could be like that.
Possibly. It might. And I mean, that was just a beta level, so
yeah,
I could
true. It was only
some,
like 47.
Like,
what if they had a wisp? What if they had a wisp made out of rings? That would be weird.
No.
Yes.
No.
I want to see something like that. Just a wisp with rings or something.
But I think they're also going to be taking like some things from Lost World. Maybe not all of them, because like if you look at the beginning of the trailer, Sonic's pose
is like
the
Lost
World
pose.
Oh yeah,
yeah,
that is.
I actually really admire.
Yeah, and the boost pads are from Lost World too. So it's like.
But what about the bounce pads? So.
No, this is not. Don't bring.
Well, they did
bring
say
bounce
pad. Is gonna be like
bring cancer boom.
Don't bring boom into
it.
Bounce pad.
Like, and generation, and then like Lost World was kind of like a, well. It was like Lost World's like Colors, and so yeah, they're gonna have a lot of things from Colors and Lost World.
All I know is that this game is having a darker tone than everything else.
The wisps look the same.
The wisps made me cry.
I like video games with darker tones.
Yeah, I know.
Sonic Adventure 2.
As long as they're fun.
No, this game in general, like it honestly also gives me a Sonic adventure.
Adventure feel like Sonic Adventure DX.
Like that's the main one that I get. Adventure DX.
I mean,
I honestly think this is Adventure 2 was taking place in San Francisco, right?
San Francisco zone.
Sure.
Because in the background of the gameplay, you can see the same bridge that Tails is on, was like Route 99 or something.
I mean, like Sega admitted they took its inspiration from San Francisco, like, because like the team who developed Sonic Adventure 2 was in San Francisco.
Should we talk about the music in the game?
Yo,
ooh,
can I say something?
I mean, we only heard one.
Yeah,
track.
let like, Ninja say something.
All right, go ahead.
I mean, it was confirmed who the main music makers are gonna be as far as
Jun Senoue,
but they didn't say that they weren't gonna be using multiple. So I still think that Crash 40 is a possibility.
Didn't you hear that
they say Crash 40 will be making vocals for the main theme?
Didn't you hear that Jun Senoue?
The person that worked on Sonic 3 is
going to
be on the team.
Yeah, Jun Senoue.
Yeah, Jun Senoue.
Jun Senoue. Yeah, that's how you pronounce it. Jun Senoue.
But you can also hear
him. He's coming back.
They use different tracks from
one person. One person.
If you listen really closely, you can hear his world in the background of the gameplay music. You can hear it the most at 30 seconds into it, because it's like do 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 do.
You can stop.
Yeah, it's like that. No, I love singing.
It's like right after the part Sonic was going through the loop rings, you can hear do 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 do, and then you also hear in the beginning you can hear like other music songs from past stages. I forgot which one. I think Swiss said to hear like Seaside Hill or something like that. I don't know.
I didn't hear Seaside Hill.
We haven't actually talked about the actual like modern Sonic gameplay, and I have something to say about that.
It's obviously going to be showcasing wisps.
Yeah, that. But it's like I'm really glad that they haven't abandoned the boost gameplay, because in
Lost
World they obviously like completely. Utterly abandoned their like engine, and then this time they made a new engine, the Hedgehog Engine 2, and now it looks not only like more polished, but it also looks way more beautiful, and it has like the effects that there are supposed to be.
What?
And as you can see, like when Sonic does the homing attack, like in Sonic Unleashed, where he has that trail behind him, they finally
he has like the aura.
what it was supposed to look like.
Yeah, that was going to be Omis, but got scrapped.
For some reason, I don't know why.
But they took it away.
I don't know why, but I keep on thinking that Sonic still has like a little bit of chaos energy that is like giving him that extra effect in his homing attacks. I don't know why. I just keep on thinking
that.
What do you mean by chaos energy?
Like, you know, from absorbing the Chaos Emerald to turn into Supersonic. A residue of that Chaos Emerald energy could still be in him, which is giving him that effect.
That's a theory for another.
Yo, and actually...
What is wrong with me, just for making that theory?
Speaking of the Chaos Emeralds, how do you think the game is going to give them to you?
Like, I don't know.
They could be presented in special stages like Sonic Heroes.
Battles in order to get them, or is the game just gonna hand the Chaos Emeralds?
Can I say something?
Yeah. Go ahead.
I kind of want them to bring special stages into the game somehow, but not make them
Sonic Heroes
like so cancerous. Like, I kind of like the way they did special stages in
Sonic Heroes.
Heroes and Sonic Generations 3DS, because you had the race to get the Emerald.
Generations 3DS was an improved
bad
Heroes. Because Heroes is just a nightmare.
That game gave me cancer.
Like, me personally, I kind of like that. Like, I obviously, the balls give me cancer.
Whoa, what?
unless
you're playing the PC version of Heroes, then that's when the special stages are okay. Because then you can
be completely honest. I don't see special stages fitting into this game. I kind of hope it's like something like, not that the game gives them to you, but like you have to find them. Like you have to do certain things to get to the Chaos Emeralds.
Sonic Heroes, you have like it could be like it could be like how Sonic Heroes presented them, and you have to look through different stages for an item that will give you access to the special stage after the level.
Yeah, like a key or something. Like,
yeah,
yo,
like
that, the keys. I would love to see that again. That would be awesome.
Oh my gosh.
I just don't see special stages fitting into the game. Oh,
I mean, they do fit in. All I know is that Hypersonic would never appear in a Sonic game again.
Yeah. And also, I do not want them to do Super Sonic like they did in Sonic Colors. You had to get every single Red Star ring, and that got repetitive. I don't want to be sitting around for 8 hours just trying to find Red Star ring.
I'll be right back, guys.
Yeah, I never even bothered looking.
Hold on, wait, guys. I'll be right back. All right.
God.
All right, Pete.
Intermission, everyone. We're back from this small intermission. All right, let's continue.
All right, so what if Modern Sonic had this? Well, I mean, he obviously does have the boost, but what if he also had the spin dash? How would that work out? Like,
I can't see Modern Sonic having a spin dash.
Like, yeah, boost no, and spin dash. No,
I can imagine.
That would completely ruin the experience, honestly.
Yeah.
I could imagine what he'd look like with it, though.
I'll be perfectly fine.
Or what if you could, like, enable the spin dash? Like, enable or disable?
Nah, not even that.
Yeah, even if they did.
Yeah, the spin dash in 3D.
That's only good for Dreamcast and Classic Sonic.
If you guys think about that, I mean, Lost World got a lot of hate simply because it had the spin dash.
Even though
Sonic Lost World, if you know how to use spin dash, can compare to the adventure games.
It didn't feel bad. Spin dash in Lost World, it actually felt kind of nice to like go fast.
I mean, it did
form,
feel
like,
nice, but it got
yeah,
a lot
like,
of hate.
But since Forces is taking that Colors Generations route, then you know.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
Yeah, that's why. That's why they brought back.
Specifically, at the beginning of the trailer,
yeah, the trailer creators
from the makers
Sonic Colors
of Sonic
and
Colors and Sonic.
Yeah, that's why they brought back Sonic Team, so they can so they can revive that same feeling that the players got from playing Sonic Colors and Generations.
And Generations, yeah.
Yeah, that
gotta go fast.
Both of those games were extremely fun, and I believe that this game will also be fun, but will have a darker tone to it. Like, not all the scenes will be fun and games.
Yeah, it's not gonna like, be like it's not gonna have that Colors pull on.
Ooh, speaking like, of scenes.
I hope they do.
Oh wait, I have something to say after Ninja.
I hope they do have
guys.
Yeah.
What's cracking?
I am hoping and praying that they have scenes, like cutscenes, that look as beautiful as the trailer and Sonic Unleashed cutscenes.
Like, yeah, well, I don't want game animated cutscenes. I actually want like CGI fully animated cutscenes. Maybe that's why they're taking up until December. Maybe they're just maybe they're animating the cutscenes with that beautiful, beautiful, gorgeous CGI.
Bro, this needs to be the next Sonic Unleashed. That's what.
Yeah, this game gives me a Sonic Unleashed vibe.
I would love to see that.
Where the opening cutscene
is actually
gorgeous.
My favorite Sonic game of all time.
Right? I mean, like, my most favorite is probably Sonic 3. But Sonic Unleashed is one of my most favorite modern Sonic games. Yeah. In terms of gameplay and story.
Yeah, in terms of gameplay and story, that's, like, one of the best games.
Like, yeah, this game also gives me an Unleashed vibe, mostly because of the story.
Yeah.
So many vibes.
Like, if you think about it, you know, Eggman blew up the planet. You know, and Unleashed.
True. Yeah, true.
Eggman pretty much took over at that point when he blew up the planet, kind of.
Yeah, kind of.
And then, you know, with Sonic Forces, you know, Eggman took over the planet.
I mean, Sonic obviously has to team up with someone.
Yeah, like, yeah. Yeah.
So yo, they have to bring...
Yeah, like, yeah.
Sega Dick Profounder would be a new character.
Yo.
Like, there probably would be a new character. I want them to,
Me and Marcel talked about this, but do you think at the beginning of the game, like as soon as you boot it up, as soon as you click like story mode, and if there's going to be any other game modes, it would show like the events, like you know what happened to Sonic Boom last year, where it shows the events what happened at the end of the game, and then it would tell you what happened before
Yeah,
the
like
event.
What if it does
to
do
be
that?
Honest, I think that would actually
yeah,
that would fit so well with the story.
I
mean, like,
that might work.
That was the only good part of Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric.
Not like the way Sonic Boom handled it.
Yeah, like in
like,
Sonic
know,
Boom, like where it shows Sonic getting shot and then falling to the ground, and then it says 2 days later.
It's
I
like
in Sonic Forces.
Yeah,
Sonic
like,
Forces.
Yeah, it showed.
If it showed the destroyed world and it said, and it shows Sonic like grinning. It shows like a trailer basically.
Yeah,
and then it goes back.
Theory.
Yeah, and then it says like
theory.
3 days yes later. I mean, earlier. What's cracking, Brandon?
Is it the game theory?
Okay, so my theory. What if, when all of this happened, Sonic finally decided that it was time to take down Eggman once and for all, so he joins together with all of his friends in Classic Sonic and, like, pretty much leads them, like,
to
not
Eggman's
really like
death.
A military leader, but like an actual leader to make the resistance and to take him down once and for all. What if, like, this was, like, pretty much the kind of final countdown?
Oh, no, I don't think it would be the final game of the series.
Honestly,
I mean, I'm not saying it's the final game of the series, obviously. I'm just saying, like, he tries to take him down once and for all.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, like, basically, like...
do that, but he's gonna, like, have the demeanor. I mean...
Wait. What I just realized... Bro,
shut your phone off, bro. What are you doing?
Yeah, speaking of that, hold up, before we get into anything else, since apparently Lost World isn't canon, how did Eggman get out of that time paradox that he was left in Generations?
Right.
That's what I want to know. I hope they explain that, because I actually want to know.
Wait, what? Lost World isn't canon?
Yeah, apparently. Lost World isn't canon.
Hello? Are you sure about that? Because just because they didn't show it at the doesn't mean that
I've
it's not canon.
I've seen videos on YouTube that like proved why it couldn't be canon, and the facts were pretty solid and why it couldn't be canon.
That doesn't. I'll believe it when Sega actually admits it's not canon.
Yeah.
I really hope Sega puts out an official Sonic timeline. We really need one.
Simple explanation. Cause Sega. That's all it is.
Cause Sega.
The reason
I swear.
Hold on. Let's all join in at the same time to say Sega. One, two, three.
Sega!
Yo, I can't wait to edit this video because I'm going to add in the little, whoa.
You don't need other YouTube in this video.
Yo, I actually can't wait to edit this video because I'm going to, after we say Sega.
Add the Sega jingle with
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, same. But anyways,
yo, let's talk about
our next topic, or is that the end?
Let's talk about the enemies, because obviously we have the big death thing-ish robots.
Okay, I have something to say about the enemies too.
Oh, come on.
I have something to say about everything.
Bro.
Bruh.
Okay. So, okay. Have you guys ever noticed how Eggman's robots are always, always colored and vibrant? Like, look at Sonic Lost World, Sonic.
Every Sonic game till this point.
Like, all of the games that he is in, his enemies, badniks, bots, whatever, are always colored.
Yeah.
Well, in this trailer, they are specifically gray out. And even the Death Egg robots are grayed out. But this means... Eggman is the one that took over the world, but someone else is behind the wheel, too?
Ninja, sorry to disprove that, but
let me finish. I know what you're about to say. But, dude, like, I know that Eggman is probably gonna be, like, the overseer of this, but maybe he has someone to help him. Not necessarily ruling with him, guide him taking over the world. And that's why we need a resistance. That's why we need Sonic Forces.
They said,
That's a good thing.
I know what they said, boy. I don't care.
They said the game was complete, so everything was in color, right? But, yeah, that could be true. I would really like that, too.
Yeah, I was wondering. Yeah, they didn't color them because it was probably just like a last-minute demo.
Cool if there was another
I would love to see that if the CGI trailer, they were colored,
so it's like...
No, I've been recording for it.
Is Nega Eggman canon? I forgot.
No,
I don't think he is.
He's in Rush.
Yeah, he's not canon.
I got in trouble for saying.
He's in another universe.
When I was younger, I got in trouble for saying Eggman Nega.
Oh my god!
Because my dad thought I said the N-word, so he said don't say that again.
Yeah, I remember my dad the same thing. Like my brother said, he's like, you said what? I was like, no, it's Eggman Nega.
You know, like Nega.
Yeah, with an N E, not an N.
It's like Neo Sega.
Alright. Do we have anything? Oh, speaking about the enemies. I feel like there might be a little bit more time traveling, because it looks like there's a lot of enemies from the past, like the old guy from Sonic 2.
Sonic Heroes.
Oh yeah, yeah.
The egg pawns from Sonic Heroes, the badniks from Sonic 2. So,
those spinny things from Advance. Those purple things.
I have no idea what you're talking about with the spinny things.
Oh, you mean those like purple?
Very descriptive.
Yeah, the purple things.
Very descriptive. Those spinny.
Very descriptive.
Very descriptive.
Yep, I have the best descriptive names.
And that's why your channel sucks.
I don't know why.
Oh my god.
My channel is better than Dark Spawn's.
Kidding.
Should we talk about the red rings and what they might unlock?
Oh yeah,
that's a good question.
Now I know what it's called—a bladed spinner.
What?
Huh?
It's called a bladed spinner.
That name sucks.
I know.
Okay, that's a terrible name. Let's talk about the red rings.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
From previous
what if they unlock? What if they? Hold on. Wait. Let me say something. What if they unlock new moves?
Like Sonic in a Secret Rings?
No.
Yes.
Wait. I kind of want that, but at the same time, I don't. It's like...
Like, not like...
Like, I want...
And I think you'll be going down the generations road too much.
Yeah, like,
I want modern Sonic and classic Sonic gameplay the same. They pretty much the same, but if they have like something like the time stopper or something like that, maybe I would allow that. But I don't know.
Oh wait, hold on. I have a topic that I think I've heard from the live streamer Sega. I think Sega said like the modern sections will have 2D sections.
Yeah, like underwater.
Yeah, like underwater, like just
playing you know, underwater.
Like how, like, yeah, you know, like how in Colors and Generations they'll just like switch to a 2D.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Playing underwater in 3D would be ass. So, yeah.
Whoa.
What? I think I would want Modern Sonic to be completely 3D. Like,
no.
Modern Sonic has always been 3D and 2D, and then Dreamcast Sonic is obviously full 3D, and then Classic Sonic is full 2D.
Playing underwater in a modern Sonic game would be like playing underwater in a Mario game. It would just suck.
Think about how they placed you underwater in 3D in Lost World 3DS. That's how cancer it would be.
Oh yeah, yes, yeah, exactly. That was
completely.
I hate Lost.
That was, I actually like, never played the 3DS version of Lost World.
I played like the demo, and I think I did have the full game before I sold it because it was complete garbage.
At the time, I enjoyed the game. Surprising.
I mean, it's okay.
Well, do we have any final topics for this speculation?
I'm about to hit about 40 minutes of the video, so
yes, at 30.
I'd like to wrap this up.
Well, I have 34.
I do not want this to take too long to render for him.
Well, it's like we talked about the plot, talked about the gameplay styles, talked about the music. The music. Collectibles.
I might need to download some more music for this gameplay. I mean, not this gameplay. Like
this
like,
discussion.
Yeah, this discussion.
Discussion. Not a game.
So this is it.
I think we talked about everything.
Alright, then.
Oh, wait. I got one more thing.
Wait,
oh yeah, that's right.
We didn't talk about characters. Oh my god.
Oh wait, let me talk about this one. Let me talk about this one.
Classic and modern Sonic.
Yeah.
And then we have
Knuckles and Amy, but like those are gonna be NPCs.
And some of the chaos, bruh. And some of the Chaotix appearing.
I mean.
Oh yeah, because they did. They did. Hold on.
What I want to see.
Amy and the Chaotix.
What I want to see? I want to see Mighty. Can somebody bring back my boy Mighty?
I don't I don't see it happening.
Like, what if he does come back though? Like, what if he has like?
For what?
I mean, like, what purpose? To be honest, what purpose would he be in Sonic Forces?
I mean, to be honest,
like, I know, like, the world needs help.
Yeah, like, I know the world is in danger and stuff, and Eggman pretty much took over. But I mean, I don't see him being in any more Sonic games. Unless it's like
I really don't. Unless he's in a poster or something. Like
yeah, that. Unless he's like a cameo or something. Other than as a playable character, I don't see it.
I didn't say a playable character.
I only see him as an NPC.
Right.
Him he's being an NPC. Character. But what if they did revive him? Like, he's only been living through the comics now, but I want to see him in the game again.
I mean, only as a cameo. Only like in Generations where you're just like, you know, missing, you know, the missing posters.
Yeah, maybe that.
Yeah, but like other than that, nah.
But I am very, very, very happy that they are bringing all the characters, at least as it seems.
I kind of want to see Silver, to be honest.
Silver's definitely going to be in it.
Yeah,
Silver's,
he probably is.
I want to see all the main characters.
There's going to be something with time travel where Silver's world is affected too, so he has to come back to the past.
They're bringing back Knuckles, Amy, and the Chaotix. Like, they have to bring back characters like Shadow, Silver, and stuff like that.
True, like, so true.
Yeah. And I would love to see Sonic or Shadow and Silver playing the role again.
Oh, wait. This is an off topic.
That's not going to happen.
This is an off topic statement, but Sonic Colors DS was off on so many levels.
We can talk about that off the video.
Right?
Like, seriously, that game.
Okay, is that seriously it that we have?
Let's see. We talked about story, characters, plot, levels, enemies, collectibles. Let's see. Character designs. I'm trying to think. I think that's it.
Alright, do you guys mind if I do the outro?
Sure, go ahead.
Alright. Well, that's going to have to be it for this video. I thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys did enjoy, please leave a big fat thumbs up on all of these beautiful
thumbs up, my
channels.
Boy.
And also be sure to subscribe to my channel and their channels if you haven't done so already to make sure that you don't miss a single minute of gameplay, speedruns, or anything else that we do for the matter. But without further ado, we're going to cut this out. So, peace. My name is Bam, and take
care. Peace.